How weird. It's not like Dad to leave the lights on after closing up. Where did everyone go? Damn, I'm clumsy. Well, I could get there from the store using the basement stairs. What the hell? That door is reinforced with steel. I doubt I could hear anything on the other side. Mm-mm. It's gone now. But how did it get in there in the first place? The room is empty. I don't know what else I was expecting. Here you are. Who? I must be hallucinating. How weird. Threw something away in the waste paper basket. If this is some kind of sick joke, it's not funny. You ever open again.
I had another nightmare last night. I was lying in bed and I felt something staring at me from the corner of the bedroom. I knew that there was something there, something very real, but I didn't dare turn on the light because I didn't want to see whatever it was. I was afraid of going mad if I did. So, perhaps in a rush of panic, courage or folly, I turned on the light and woke up. I got out of bed and went to the bathroom to wash my face, attempting to lift away the heavy feeling of something pressing on my chest. Then, I saw my reflection in the mirror. The face looking back at me was grotesque. It was deformed and changed color, and it was jolting about with despair. It was banging against the glass time and again, trying to warn me or to escape the place it was in. It seemed as if it was screaming, but I couldn't hear anything. The scene was so horrific that, well, I woke up again. I was inside the bathroom, standing before the shattered mirror.
Yes. Christ, something's wrong. Dad, where in the world have you gone? Oh.
Dad? Are you in there?
Nope. What?
If this is a dream, somebody wake me up already. What's going on? Huh? even slightly normal. Inside my head.
Whatever you do, don't listen to the box.
I could have broken my legs. Good. Oh. Mm-hmm. Yes. I don't remember leaving the lights on. Anyway, let's see how much of a mess the house was left in this time. Dad? What the hell is this? Where are you? This place is impossible. What am I even doing here right now? I must be losing my mind. Okay. Let's see whether I'm able to follow the bloody trail. Completely insane. Christ, I can't get it open. Shit, it's close. I've got to hurry. There's a wardrobe here. Now is the time to use that luminol. Yes. This is the wardrobe that Dad cleaned off in the courtyard. What's that tape doing here? In the office, and you're not. Dad. Let's see if I can open it with this.
There was Father. God. Don't even want to think about what must have happened in his final moments. As he was hanging from that noose with the bloody music box on the table next to him. I don't want to think about it, but somehow, very deep within me, I know the song was playing throughout his agony, stalking him to the very frontier between life and death. God. At least we had found the music box, and we knew where it came from. The Grant Amsburg Auction, it said, on the list of product lots, alongside an address. According to Husha, things had improved after returning the box to Faba. So by returning it to its owner, perhaps we might be able to solve all this. It sounded unlikely, but considering my hallucinations, the things we found at the antique shop and Mr. Faba's terrible end, if it could all come to some good, we had to try it. Isolated far from the world, in a holiday manor that must be about 100 years old, the lady who owned the sinister box awaited us, being on the inside of the cover. Good. Good for her, then.
Do you think that someone could actually live in this place?
I don't know. The papers from the auction stated that the owner had sold most of her furniture, but that she still lived here. Mr. Grant? Hello? This place gives me the creeps. Hello? Are you Miss LeGrant? Ariadne LeGrant?
Amsburg?
Pardon me?
LeGrant Amsburg. It's hyphenated.
Oh. Well, my name is Daniel Neuer, and I work for a publishing firm. Through a series of chance occurrences, I found something I believe is yours. It seems crazy, but when you listen to it...
That's its box.
No. I think it belongs to you. On the cover, it says...
I wasn't speaking to you. Thank you for bringing it back, Mr. Neuer. Have you listened to it?
Yes.
He has listened to it.
Damn.
Just what I was thinking. Let's get out of this place.
Absolutely. I'm glad we got rid of that thing.
Me too. I'm sorry it wasn't in time to...
I know. Thanks.
Come on. I'll take you to the shop. Thanks for letting me sleep here.
Of course. Whatever you need. I'll even let you sleep on the couch.
It's more than enough. I just need a couple of nights. That will suffice. I don't feel like staying in an empty house after everything that's gone on.
You can stay as long as you want. Seriously.
Thanks.
At least I know you won't drink my wine.
Very funny. Hey, Sophie?
Oh no!
Daniel, are you all right?
That had not been a nightmare. I was awake, for certain. It was a hallucination. A hallucination like those described by Faber in his letter, shortly before hanging himself from a beam in his office. A hallucination. Or something worse. Much worse. Had it done any good to return the music box to its owner? Husha might have the answer, but his whereabouts was still unknown. And his trail seemed to have gone cold as the days passed by. Perhaps in his office, somewhere in his papers, among the documents he was researching while delving into the box's origins. Maybe there would be some clue in there as to where he had gone or what he had done. Something that would help us to follow his footsteps. I had to find Sebastian Husher, but this time, my life depended on it.